Alright everybody, welcome back to another Genshin video. In today's video, we'll be going over the hypostatic symphony event that has just dropped in Genshin. Now, this event's been up for maybe a day or two, I'm not exactly sure. But we're going to be going over the different rewards that you can get, as well as going over the event just in general. Now, there are 7 different challenges for this event, each of which will gather you 60 pyro gems for a total of 420 pyro gems, along with, you know, other stuff. Now, for the score part of the event, after killing one of the hypostatics, you'll be getting points, and here are the rewards for said point total. Now, you'll be getting 2 of each blue talent level up book. So, Freedom, Resistance, Ballad, Prosperity, Digilence, and Gold. You'll be getting 2 of each of those until you get to 6k points. Now, you'll be getting purple EXP material for your characters in this event as well. That totaling out to be 32 of the purple books, which is about 640k EXP for your characters. That's very nice. I know everyone's kind of running low. Now we have a Celebration Hypostatus name card. It looks very good. I'm not going to lie. That looks really clean. It's kind of plain, but you know, it looks good. You'll be gaining also, after 15.5k down to 20k, you'll be gaining 32 of the blue weapon mat materials. So 320k weapon EXP. That is very nice. Now, I'm already here at the hypostatic symphony little thing. Whenever you just click on it, it'll instantly teleport you here. Now, let's actually get into the event. This is like my 4th time recording this because something would just go fucking wrong. But enough of that. Before I get into the actual event, if you notice down here in the bottom right corner, there's going to be characters who get a buff in this event with their damage. So for this one, Ganyu, Zhongli, or Zhongling? I don't know how to pronounce her name. I think it's Zhongling. But Diluc and Changyun also get a buff during the electric part of the event. Now, all the different challenges are going to have character buffs. So going down to the wind one, we have, what is this, official Kaching, Albedo, and I don't remember Waterboy's name. For the stone event, Klee, Razor, fucking Noel and Bennett, and we can't actually see those. Okay, I didn't know if you were able to see those afterwards, but all right. Going into here, this part is very interesting. So you can see a score multiplier up here. So for easy, you get 1x, normal, you get 1.5, hard is 2.5, and expert is 4.5 score bonus. That's really cool. Makes it really easy to farm up those points. Now moving down, there's actual challenges that you can click on that will gather you points. You can click on all of these, I'm pretty sure, for the maximum points that you can get. But just going over them really quickly, there's times that you can get this. Opponent's HP is increased. They got resistances. Healing effectiveness for your party is decreased. Active characters' HP, their attack is decreased. just all sorts of really interesting ones. Now, at the very bottom, they actually have buffs for your characters if you wanted to do that. Characters' HP is greater than 90%, they get crit rate and crit damage. And then all party members' shield strength is increased by 30%. So for the sake of this video, I'm gonna do the top one. Can't exceed over 300 seconds. Enemies' HP is increased by 25%. And I guess critical damage critical damage decreased by 50%. I guess that's what we're gonna do in this video. So I'll be getting a total of 250 points from this, and we can pick up characters right here. So let us put in Chongyun, and let us take Fischl out for a fire user, which I'm gonna just bring Amber because I have not worked on my Zongying just yet. And let us begin. I am very interested to see the attack patterns this time around because they're supposed to be different. So I am very hyped to actually see this. Okay, so they have like little mini, I don't know what these are. Okay. Oh, very interesting. So you can't actually damage them until you take care of this right here, which you can't actually use physical attacks with. So you're gonna have to be using actual attacks. Okay. Ooh. Okay, so little orbs they shoot out this time around. Okay, easy mode. Oh, okay, I see why easy mode is, well, easy. Buckhand is level 20. Did not notice that before. Ooh, okay. That was cool. Finish that one off right there. Oh, that actually did not kill. Okay. Destroy the revival. Is that the only one left? Yeah, okay. Okay, the attack patterns were really cool this time around. Very different as well. Okay. Very, very interesting. We're gonna do one more. And that's gonna be probably the wind one. Let me turn around here. Okay. So yeah, I'm probably gonna try this wind one next. So, Fischl. Right, I only got Fischl out of these guys. So I'm gonna do the same, stuff that we did last time, which is those three right there. Now I know I'm only doing easy in this video, but that's just for us to see just kind of what the attack patterns and stuff are. But I'll probably be doing a stream over this event whenever the actual rest of it comes out, if it comes out. Well, it's supposed to come out, I think the full event comes out in like 2 days. What are these right here? Can you not damage him? No, you can. Interesting. I'm guessing he might like restore HP or something with those. Okay, this is kind of the same type of deal as in the original one so far. I don't know how I feel about the wind one so far. There we go. I don't know. Damn it. I suck at fucking the wind glider. That's fucking... Damn it. Man, I suck at this. But it doesn't help that it has, like, more wind things to help you traverse that thing. Come on. I only have one more left. Two more left. This. That. I think that's it, right? I don't see no more. So is he just gonna... Okay. It's just like the other one where he, like, regains his HP after you take all those. Okay. What do I think of this event? So far, I think it's actually pretty okay. Even though we did the easy ones in this video. The attack patterns that the new hypostases do look really good. But the at least the wind one kind of had sort of the same type of attacks as the original did. The electric one had different moves and honestly may have been harder than the wind one. The only thing with that wind one is having to move around trying to get those orbs so it doesn't regain the HP. Sucks. Hate doing that shit, but... overall, I give this event 8 out of 10. You know, it's fun, different attacks, getting to see different stuff. We will be doing a stream over the entirety of this. We'll even be doing, like, expert and stuff on the stream whenever the full event comes out. But, yeah, that's it. I hope you guys have a good day. I'm out.